The people who walked in darkness have seen a great light. Those who dwelt in a land of deep darkness, on them has light shined. You have multiplied the nation, you have increased its joy. They rejoice before you as with joy at the harvest, as men rejoice when they divide the spoil. For the yoke of his burden and the staff for his shoulder, the rod of his oppressor, you have broken as on the day of Midian. For every boot of the tramping warrior in battle tumult, and every garment rolled in blood will be burned as fuel for the fire. For to us a child is born, to us a son is given, and the government will be upon his shoulder, and his name will be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. Of the increase of his government and of peace, there will be no end. Upon the throne of David and over his kingdom to establish it and to uphold it with justice and with righteousness, from this time forth and forevermore. The zeal of the Lord of hosts will do this. In those days, a decree went out from Caesar Augustus that all the world should be enrolled. This was the first enrollment, when Quirinius was governor of Syria. And all went to be enrolled, each to his own city. And Joseph also went up from Galilee, from the city of Nazareth, to Judea, to the city of David, which is called Bethlehem, because he was of the house and lineage of David, to be enrolled with Mary, his betrothed, who was with child. And while they were there, the time came for her to be delivered. And she gave birth to her firstborn son, and wrapped him in swaddling clothes, and laid him in a manger, because there was no place for them in the inn. And in that region there were shepherds out in the field, keeping watch over their flock by night. And an angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were filled with fear. And the angel said to them, "Be not afraid, for behold, I bring you good news of a great joy which will come to all the people. For to you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, who is Christ the Lord. And this will be a sign for you. You will find a baby wrapped in swaddling clothes and lying in a manger." And suddenly there was an angel, there with the angel, a multitude of the heavenly host praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace among men with whom he is pleased."
Yet in that dark street shining, Thank you. Come adore and praise.
no reasonable person believes that Jesus was born amid the cold of winter on or around December 25th. If the shepherds were out at night in the fields, it was spring, by the way, not winter. And there's no way to know whether Jesus was born when half spent was the night, either. They didn't have clocks like we do, we have to say. So why would we listen to these pieces here tonight that speak of Jesus being born in the middle of the night, at midnight, midwinter? Is it just sentimentality? Wouldn't we be better to stick with things that we can prove historically? No, we wouldn't. Because as the feast of Christmas was being established in the early centuries of the church, December 25th was chosen not because anyone thought that Jesus was literally born on that date. Because in the ancient world, the winter solstice occurred on or around December 25th. That is the day wherein we have the least light throughout the whole year. From that day on until the end of June, the light gets longer and longer. We get more and more light. And this is the reason why we celebrate Christmas on December 25th. It symbolizes the coming of the light that banishes the darkness definitively. The psalm says, "The heavens are telling the glory of God." And in our celebration of Christmas, we see that Christ is told, he's revealed, even in the simple rhythm of light and darkness that waxes and wanes throughout the calendar year. St. John himself tells us that Christ is the light that shines in the darkness. And even more, he's not just the light, he's the source of all light. In his light, we see light. But even this is not just nice symbolism, because the coming of the light, the birth of Christ, is good news. And it's only good news in the context of the bad news. Because before Christ, as the prophet Isaiah tells us tonight, most dramatically, he says that we walked in darkness, that we were in a land of great darkness. And through our own choice in our first parents that we've seen displayed for us tonight, we left the light of God's friendship and we chose to live in the darkness of pride and of sin. But God, in his infinite love and mercy for us, has given us a child. To us, a son is given, and not just any son, but the Son, God's own Son, a Savior, Jesus Christ the Lord. And in him, God has joined his divinity, his light, the source of all light, to our humanity, to our broken, darkened humanity, to save it. As the carol has it tonight, he comes to share our every load. And the call of this season of Advent, of these days in preparation for the coming feast of Christmas, is that we all recognize the darkness that we as a race were in before Christ, and that each one of us, in and through our own fault, is in. We read the prophets, reminding us of the blindness, the darkness, the helplessness of living in sin without Christ. And we have to look within our own hearts and see this darkness, see this blindness that our own sins have caused in us. And then we can hear the prophecy of the Savior. Then we can yearn, we can hope, we can look forward to the one, the only one who can save us from that darkness. Because he's the one that comes to bring light, the light that will save us and lead us home to the Father. And the call of Advent these days is to enter into both the despair, "Be comforted, my people," and the hope of salvation history, "Glory to God in the highest." And these psalms, these hymns, these inspired songs that we hear tonight, these make straight the path in our heart to entering into these realities. They sing of the dark winter of our sins, into which our Savior comes, into which he is born. Christ is born in midwinter. He is born in the middle of the night, not of just some mundane reality, but of the darkness of hopelessness in the face of our sinfulness. Christ breaks into that and brings his light and brings his salvation. And he brings us to recognize the glory. This evening brings us to recognize that glory. That is the coming of Christ the Lord. These songs put in our hearts the relief, the gratitude, the joy that comes from knowing that we indeed have a Savior, Jesus Christ the Lord.
Certain shepherds brought tidings of